Welcome back to Fox 8 News in the Morning. We have been waiting a year for this segment. Rich with tradition and symbolism, treasured and beautiful ingredients, Easter bread, something Tim and Michael Kudrowski know all so well. And we see them on the show many times a year. Every time you guys are here, we just love to see you guys.
We do.
You're so much fun.
We're still on our Poochki hangover from last time.
Yeah. I'm still on a Poochki hangover, can you tell?
Truly.
We're pulling it together for Easter time for everyone.
How
Don't worry.
How many Poochkis did you guys go through on Fat Tuesday?
Over 85,000.
85,000.
These are handmade. I mean, it's just me and him and a bunch of Polacks back there rolling Poochkis.
So
it's not like...
It is so fun, though. It really
is.
And you know, with the spring season and everything growing and coming to life, just like the significance of Easter, that's why we make this healthy risen bread with a lot of fruits and flavors inside of it to signify the rising of Christ for the Easter season.
Yes, yes.
So this is the Polish babka bread, and this is what we're traditionally going to do. Michael would show you that we do the flour.
So we're starting from
scratch
for this.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we don't have a hand mixer, or we don't have a mixer here, and you're going to want to.
We do it with our hands.
You're going to want to do a mixer.
It's the best way.
Hey, that's what my grandma used to do.
So I love it.
Okay.
So we have the flour, the sugar. We'll have the recipe online. Add some almonds, and we're going to add the. Milk mixture, usually what the traditional is to scald the milk. And the scalding of the milk gives the bread a little bit more of a healthy flavor, like a hearty flavor, healthy.
How do you scald the milk?
You put the milk on the stove and you wait for it to heat up, and just till it starts to smoke and you get a skim on it.
No kidding.
Then it's scalded and you get a better flavor out of the milk that way.
I had no idea.
Yeah. So then you add, so in order to signify the spices that they embalm Christ's bodies with, we use the orange peel, the lemon rind, and then you squeeze the whole juice of that fruit into the mixture, which gives the bread, you can smell it as the bread that we're going to work here.
It's amazing.
So what we're going to do is we're just going to roll it out.
Okay.
See, you can feel it. See, it's kind of sticky.
It's fun.
Yeah,
it's
fun. Michael, will you spray that pan and
streusel it? Yeah, this is probably the most important part of your process, especially at home.
Okay.
When you get your pan, your bundt pan, whatever you want to use, you want to spray it up.
It's good.
But then you want
to make it longer, huh?
We got a recipe for a butter streusel in there, and if you put the butter streusel in, and then you toss it around like so, that will make the bread will actually release out of the pan.
That's perfect. That's
Otherwise, you're going to be pulling it out of the pan and trying to eat it on Easter day.
Well, we don't want that.
We don't want that.
So also, along with the spray and the streusel is a releasing agent, so it helps if it enhances the flavor of the dough and it helps release the. A babka from the pan when you do it. So now the bread that you have done, you just circle it.
Yours
and put
it great.
In there.
Okay.
That's
all right.
Fantastic.
And then what do we
just
do?
Overlap.
Yeah, just like that.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Overlap just like that.
Okay.
Okay. Now.
So that's
you're gonna,
what we have there.
It looks like that. And then we're going to spray the top with the release, with the pan release, which will give it a shiny top.
Ooh.
And then we're also going to put the rest of the streusel on top of that.
Oh, yum.
Along with the slivered almonds. So that has lemon peel, orange rind, slivered almonds, scalded milk, sugar, butter, and an excess amount of yeast to help it rise to this type of
flavor. Can you believe that? This looks like
this.
That.
Yeah.
It's a whole lot of Polish love right there.
So what we do with this is after they bake, and that's what this looks like when it's baked,
right.
It's just a release, so you just pop it, and we give it such a look.
Oh my goodness, that's amazing!
Isn't it beautiful?
And then you see that.
So like what we did over here, we actually glazed it and put the sprinkles with the cross to help to signify the crucifixion of Christ
with the Easter crosses.
Right? Okay. And then what we do is this just looks good enough to dive into.
Yeah, it does.
Even better, if you're making these at home and you want to...
Oh, yeah, now you show it.
Yeah. Just in time.
Here's all the good stuff. Yeah.
If you're making these at home and you want to impress someone, you color some eggs and then don't cook them. Put them in the bottom. And then when you pop it out, you come like that.
Yeah.
And you have Easter eggs.
They
bake into the bread, and they're hard
boiled.
They're hard baked at that point.
Don't
use plastic ones.
And the key word is bread.
Bread, right.
Wow.
So, yeah, it's a whole bunch of Polish fun at Easter time for us.
Well, so you can decide to make it, because we do have the recipe on our website. It's also going to be on our Fox 8 Pinterest page as well. But then, if you just want to go.
Come in and.
You guys just do it.
Have an Easter snoogle, you know.
How do you, do you just break this off, or how do you?
You can cut those in half. You can wear them as bunny ears. You can do whatever you want with them.
We don't eat them, though.
I'm talking about the bread.
The bread. Yeah.
Wayne always wanted to break bread with you, so I think this is the perfect time.
Right? Let's do it. Okay, let's break bread together.
Well, let's do it.
Okay, let's do it.
Do you want an egg?
No. Okay. I just take the ring.
No, those are really hard.
That's
a
huge piece.
Look at that.
Oh, my goodness.
And
you really have to.
Right. That's gorgeous.
I meant the
snoogle. All right, you do that. I'm going in for a snoogle. Yeah. The snoogles are so good.
Thank you.
That's okay. The best.
Great no problem.
All right, we are going to take a short break just so we can enjoy this. Check them out, Kodrowski's Bakery. Tim, Michael, thank you guys for being with us. We love you so much.
Thank you.
Happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
Have a blessed one. All right. We'll be right back. Stay close.
Fox 8 Recipe Box is brought to you by Dean Supply.